Sustainability is like meditation. It should come from within, from our soul. That is why when we say the color of denim is not blue, it is green, we mean it from our heart.
Do you know how much water it takes to make one denim trousers you wear? It takes up to 60 liters. But there's one company who makes the same denim trousers for just 6 liters. Meet Mr. Srihari Balakrishnan of KG Fabrics, a Coimbatore-based company who follows a lot of sustainable practices. Sir, welcome to the show. Please tell me about your venture, sir.
Thank you, Manjunath. This is a family-owned company. Kannapuram Mills is the first company of the KG group of companies. It was a spinning venture. And sometime in 2010, we started a weaving venture called KG Fabrics to make denim. We already have a previous company called KG Denim, which also makes denim home textiles and bottom weights. This company is, this manufacturing facility is located at the Sipcot Perundura Industrial Complex, owned by the government of Tamil Nadu. It's in there. Right from the start, when we started it sometime in 2010, we said it has to be very clean green venture with zero solid discharge and zero liquid discharge. We spent a lot of time and effort and research into doing that. We started with like a normal denim fabric manufacturing company, anywhere from 60 to 100 liters. But with time, as we understood technology better, as we understood chemistry better, as we understood science better, we were able to bring it down to 6 liters. Even though we give an official written guarantee for 15 liters per meter of denim fabric, we continue to maintain at 6 liters. We have got this audited by various auditors, which includes TUV-NOT, CIA, various companies have audited this and they have approved this. We are also connected to the Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board online. We have online metering. We are one of the few companies in India. In Tamil Nadu itself, only total of 10 companies. All over India, probably 15 companies are connected to the Pollution Control Authority, where water meters are all connected and they do an automatic water balancing. And this is verified there and reported from them also.
And you also have a beautiful statement saying that every employee is a sustainable officer. And also you have a factory on a 33-acre land which has 5,000 fruit and nut bearing trees. And this fabric industry is known for producing a lot of dangerous effluents. So how do you manage this, sir, in terms of how do you balance between having safeguarding the environment, not discharging any solid and liquid waste to the earth? And how do you manage this kind of a effluent discharge, sir?
Typical denim process, making process, you wash the yarn, you dye it indigo, again you wash the yarn, and when you wash the yarn a second time, the entire about 60% of the dye only sticks to the fabric, another 40% goes in the effluent treatment. This happens in any dyeing, whether it's indigo dyeing or green dyeing or reactive dyeing or any dyeing. 30-40% of the dyes go in the washed water. So we gave a challenge to our team of technical people, saying that whoever comes out with the best, we knew how to recycle the dye back, but didn't know how to, which mechanism to use it to filter it back and which chemistry to use it. We knew the chemistry, but didn't know the mechanical aspect. So we crowdsourced the idea and people went around searching for filters, and they figured out that there's an industrial off-the-shelf filter which can be used for 50,000 rupees, which can be used to recycle the indigo denim back. So what happened was, not only did we not send the water to the effluent treatment plant back, but our dye fixing went from 60% to 90% overnight. Only thing is, we had to be a bit careful to see to that there was no excess dye sticking onto the fabric. It not only removed the amount of water which was used for washing, it increased the dye uptake. It also reduced the chemical footprint. So we are today the only factory with the lowest amount of water, lowest amount of chemical footprint, lowest amount of energy usage per meter, highest circularity in packing materials. 26% of all packing materials that come for yarn are reused into fabric packaging. Highest circularity in terms of water usage, which means that any water is 99% of the water is taken back. Highest circularity in terms of waste usage, which means that any plastic which comes in, 100% is reused into plastic pipe making in a nearby facility, and he sells off the pipes. Now, have we reached what we are supposed to reach? No, not yet. We think we have another 30% to go. We think we can do this with 4 liters of water. We are working on how to do it with 4 liters of water. We think that we can bring, we have brought in a lot of post-consumer waste polyester. So today anybody wants bottled polyester as jeans, we can make any jean with 30 to 40% bottled polyester. We have not achieved that with the post-consumer waste cotton. We are working on it. Lot of other companies are using post-consumer waste cotton. They claim to be using post-consumer waste cotton, but they will, suppose they allow 50 kilos to be used or 100 kilos to be used, 50% will go wasted. We are working on a system where 90, if we use 100 kilos, 90 kilos of post-consumer waste cotton. So we are working on more sustainable aspects. By next year, same time, we think the last 30% also we would have reached. We've told every employee, because they all live around in the schools and the children use the schools and colleges around within the next 10 kilometers, 15 kilometers radius, we say, your generation is going to enjoy what you guys leave behind, your younger generation. See to that the air is clean for them, the water is clean for them. This is the only cleanest company in India today. We can be arrogant when we say that. We are quite boastful also when we say that. But that is what we are.
And also that brings to the next question. Congratulations for getting a prestigious National Water Award from the central government. What is your advice to the fabric manufacturing industry in particular and as an industry as a whole?
We think sustainability is like meditation. It has to come from inside. There are a lot of companies who go outside and say we are sustainable. They brand themselves as sustainable, but they're not inside. No, you achieve inner peace only through meditation, and not by one or two classes of meditation, but through 2 or 3 years of constant meditation. So we now practice sustainability, wholesome sustainability, to 5 years. And I think we are a very sustainable company. We are doing this interview on a lockdown, and we see how fresh the air is or how clean the roads are. You know, what happens if every day is like this by everybody adopting very sustainable practices? It is possible when you have full renewable energy, full battery operated cars, all your factories are clean. You know, it is possible to get there, but it takes a lot of time and a lot of investment and money. We've done it with water. We are yet to do it with energy. We think we can do it with energy in the next 3 to 5 years, reduce our amount of energy that we use. So as I said, every officer is sustainable. Sustainability has to come from the inside, not from the outside. We should not do sustainable because some brands ask for organic cotton. Organic cotton is sustainable, but after that we dirty it by not so sustainable process. So anybody who's vending their wares to us, like, you know, somebody comes to and says, we are giving you organic cotton, we are giving you better cotton, initiative cotton. Somebody is saying, we are giving you very clean fiber. Other textile companies end up dirtying those fibers. We give very clean, sustainable process to those fibers and make it very clean, sustainable fabrics.
April 22nd is Earth Day. What is that one message you give to the fabric manufacturing industry and also the rest of the industry, sir?
Make the environment around you, the micro environment around you, sustainable, which is your house, your factory, your industry, wherever you're working. Automatically, every industry will, if they follow it, every person follows it, the earth will become a very clean place. So this is my message to my fellow factory people, industry people, manufacturers.
Sir, thank you very much for speaking to Smart Sustain. I wish all the best for you and also the initiatives you've taken. And thank you very much, sir.